This is an educational briefing about the Washoe Zephyr. We will talk about what it is, how it develops, and when it is most common during the year. While the true definition of a zephyr is a soft and gentle breeze, the term Washoe Zephyr was first coined by Mark Twain in his book Roughing It. Known for his satire, he ironically described the Washoe Zephyr as a peculiarly scriptural wind in that no man knoweth whence it cometh. And it is a pretty regular wind in the summertime. He further describes how the wind impacted the residents and visitors of Carson City. Now and then, blows a stagecoach over and spills the passengers, and tradition says the reason there are so many bald people there is that the wind blows the hair off their heads while they are looking skyward after their hats. Similar to what Mark Twain described, the Washoe Zephyr occurs on most summer days on the east side of the Sierra. This almost daily wind impacts areas around Reno, Carson City, and into the Great Basin, with late afternoon and early evening west winds gusting around 20 to 30 miles per hour. During stronger wind events, the combination of wind and low humidity can result in critical fire weather conditions, such that if a fire starts, it can spread rapidly. Let's start with the basics to explain how the Washoe Zephyr forms during these summer days. Wind can be created by two different mechanisms, differences in temperature or differences in pressure. The greater the surface pressure difference or thermal difference between two points, the stronger the wind. Differences in heating of near surface air creates density and pressure differences. These differences result in the formation of areas of high and low pressure. If a parcel of air near the surface is warmer relative to another parcel of air near the surface, then that air will tend to rise. This creates an area of low pressure at the surface. Air takes up a certain volume of space in the atmosphere, so space that is filled above the low pressure results in a diverted air mass elsewhere, creating high pressure at the surface in another location. This creates a pressure gradient along the surface with winds flowing from high to low pressure. Let's take a look at how this interaction between temperature differences and/or pressure differences creates the zephyr wind. Determining how strong the wind will be can be difficult when it comes to forecasting for the Reno, Carson City, Midden area. We know that the temperature differences can result in wind developing, so a forecaster here at National Weather Service Reno did some research and discovered a reliable relationship for forecasting winds at the Reno Airport during the summer months. To determine the afternoon wind gusts at the Reno Airport, we utilized the forecast maximum temperatures between Truckee and Lovelock. Let's see how this works. If the forecast high for Lovelock is 90 degrees and the forecast high of Truckee is 70 degrees, that results in a 20 degree temperature difference. With that thermal gradient in place, the local study shows that winds at the Reno Airport have a 90% or greater chance of gusting over 30 miles per hour out of the west. The best way to contact us with a question or feedback is by email or posting to our Facebook page. Our official webpage is located at www.weather.gov/Reno, but you can view our weather graphics and briefings on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. If you would like to submit a report, feel free to comment on Facebook or tweet us. Keep an eye out for future episodes that may include topics such as thunderstorms, downburst winds, and outflow winds. Thanks for listening.